So around about 1 in 300 people in the world are legally blind. But the majority of those, up to 90%, have some level of light perception.
That's Stephen Hicks, a neuroscientist at the University of Oxford.
In developed countries, the major one is age-related macular degeneration, where you lose your central vision. It becomes darker and darker, and you can only use your peripheral vision to recognise objects and obstacles, and it's really hard to see faces and read words. The other one is glaucoma or retinitis pigmentosa, where you lose your peripheral vision, leading you generally to tunnel vision, which means you're prone to bumping into obstacles. You can still potentially read and recognise faces, but gradually that goes and you lose night vision and things like that. The third main one is diabetic retinopathy, where you're just losing areas of sight all over.
Only 10% of people classified as blind are totally blind, meaning they have no light perception. Most can use visual aids to get by, like how those hard of hearing use hearing aids to amplify sounds. Our brains are pretty adaptable and can interpret certain information as visual. Some technologies translate visual information into sounds. This is what Stephen sounds like.
Two faces.
You can be taught to understand what the sounds mean. Other technologies tap into the light perception that visually impaired people still have.
What we're able to do with these glasses is provide spatial information about the walls and obstacles nearby, and also provide things like outlines and really crude but very fast and real-time information about where a person is, what they're doing, whether they're waving their hand. And as you've seen, as you get closer, you can also provide information about the person's face and their expressions.
It's like a crazy selfie.
So when we see the world, it's a mixture between what was coming through our eye and what our brain is putting together.
Vision is like a collage assembled by our brains, and by using these glasses Stephen is developing, visually impaired people can piece together the world again. The glasses use a 3D camera system, similar to how an Xbox Kinect senses your movements. Through them, you see the world without colour. Objects closer to you are brighter and things further away become darker.
That's augmented. They can see the real world, and they can also see a depth-based display. The combination of those two produce the whole effect.
It's crazy to think that so many people gradually lose a sense like vision and experience the world in an entirely new way. You can't regain vision you've lost, but new research and technologies can give people hope to recognise faces, avoid obstacles, and live independently.
So this is approaching something which people could possibly consider to be wearing on a day-to-day basis. And it's going to be really the first time that we've been able to do a large-scale test of augmented reality for visual impairment.
And if you haven't already, subscribe to BrainCraft for a new brainy episode every Thursday.